it's like an old friend who has finally come home after a long absence. That's how at least one customer described the recent reopening of the iconic Wei Wei store in Saco after closing down 7 years ago. Renowned for its array of penny candies, a former local school teacher is giving the old store a new life. News 8's Steve Minich has a closer look.
Way back in the 1920s, this roadside rest stop along Route 112 was known to be pretty out of the way. And that's why today it's known as the Wei Wei.
So it was way, way out of town, and the term came to stick to the store. I'm going to that store that's way, way, way out of town.
He's the boogie woogie bugle for a company bee.
Longtime Saco resident Peter Scontris has reopened the store, painstakingly recreating that old-fashioned atmosphere. And though selling canoes and ice cream is new, virtually everything else, from the wild colors, antique artifacts.
Can I get a package of the tea berry?
And of course, that counter full of candy are just the way they were decades ago.
It's very important to us that people recognize that this isn't just an ordinary candy store. This store is a wonderful example of a 1920s roadhouse.
Riding around today, the wife and I decided we'd stop in for an ice cream.
And it seems a lot of folks are stopping in. So many of them customers who first came here years ago either to grab a fistful of candy or fill up with gas. And very few don't sign in with a story.
Get gas out here in the visible gas pump. My father let me try to pump it, but I didn't have enough thought. I probably could hang off the handle, couldn't pump it.
It was pretty fun, you know, with for a kid. You just had some, you know, loose change or whatever, and you can get a whole bag of candy.
These days, that bag of candy will cost kids a little more, but so far that hasn't slowed the steady stream of people anxious to revisit this landmark store. Apparently, no longer that far out of the way.
Penny candy on one side, ice cream on the other side, keeping the atmosphere and the legacy of the store alive. It's a wonderful feeling.
In Saco, Steve Minich, News 8.